Lisa Punchinello. Lisa Punchinello was the Don's wife.
Mona Sachs. Lisa's evil twin.
Your safety's off, evil twin. You might hurt someone with that gun of yours.
Lisa's the damsel in distress. I'm the professional. I'd blow you away without batting an eye.
Sure, and you can check out my credentials splattered all over this joint.
Jack couldn't have framed you, not the state he was in. We're after the same slime bag. Angelo Quincinello's the one who murdered your friend and framed you with it.
You know this for a fact?
I've got my sources.
I don't have a clue these days. I just shoot them as they come. Who put a contract on the Archfiend?
This one's mine. I hate the guts of that sadistic wife-beater. Why not pool our bullets for this one?
I thought you'd never ask. My finger was starting to twitch.
How do you like your whiskey?
I'm easy, as long as you don't try to slip me a Mickey.
You're a real angel, Max.
It was good stuff. Tasted sweet as honey going down.
Nothing personal. Can't risk you going berserk and getting Lisa killed.
The nightmare was always the same. Violent shapes moving in darkness, old and ugly. The killer's mad laughter was a riddle filled with wicked innuendo. Somewhere, the baby was crying.
Should have known it when we found you snoring next to Lupino's corpse. A comedian, huh?
The pictures were filled with good old times.
I really love to watch cartoons. Captain Baseball Bat Boy's my favorite.
No, 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 please, God, no.
Shoot them full of holes, blow them to bits, vaporize them, disintegrate them. No matter what you do, they'll still be back, good as new.
Michelle's diary lay on the table. Michelle was working part-time in the district attorney's office. Her diary was open on today's entry, her handwriting all pretty curves.
An army dossier found its way to my desk yesterday. Valhalla? Isn't that a Norse myth? Something about Vikings? I tried to tell Max about it, but he was busy, that cute frown on his brow. Guess it's nothing, just a mix-up at the courier service.
From now on, I would always find time for her. It was a hollow promise. Too little, too late.
Max, no! Why? I didn't mean to. I'm sorry.
Murderer! You killed her!
Nothing like that ever happens in the real world.
I woke up in a bad dream. My head felt two sizes too small for my brain.
Max Payne, I envy your name.
And the killer was smiling.
Pleased to meet you. I'm Frankie the Bat Niagara.
Niagara, as in you cry a lot? He had a baseball bat and I was tied to a chair. Pissing him off was the smart thing to do.
Nothing wrong with a little laugh now and then. Take me for example. I love to watch cartoons. Cartoon violence is a fascinating thing. Let's take a break. I need to take a leak and maybe grab a cold one at the bar. Don't worry. I'll be back to finish this off. And then, it's checkout time.
You play, you pay, you bastard. He swaggered out, and the door clanged shut behind him, locks clicking into place. Everyone makes mistakes. Mine hadn't been to crack jokes about the goon with the bat. He'd have cracked my skull regardless. It hadn't even been to trust a girl with a gun. I had blindly gone after the first bad guy on my hit list when I should have been aiming further up the ladder, at the head of the Punchinello family. I couldn't bring myself to be pissed at Mona. Guess I had a soft spot for a pretty face. But when somebody decides to play baseball with your head, you tend to get sore. They had dragged me back to the basement of Lupino's hotel. I was beaten, bruised, and blue. I felt like the chair I had broken to get free. All I had was Niagara's bat, sticky with my own blood.
Without a gun, I'd be no match for Frankie's men. I'd have to play hide and seek with them.
It's Frankie's turf. He'll take care of it.
I wouldn't mind having a go at him.
It's Frankie's turf.
Yeah, I know.
Thank you.
another newspaper caption for a murder scene. Frankie had left his calling card, a Captain Baseball Bat Boy strip, next to a sewer passage filled with bodies.
You'd better not mess with Captain Baseball Bat Boy. Even my arch enemy, Bicycle Helmet Girl, swoons at the sight of me. Aha!
There were enough corpses to put a mass murderer to shame. Things were fast going from bad to worse. The men in blue had come and gone. They had decorated the place with chalk outlines and tied it together with yellow tape. The cops who had stayed behind were dead. Frankie, his boys, and I had the place all for ourselves.
Just forget about it. Hey, just forget about it. That crazy witch, you should have heard her. She was a real scream when the boys caught her trying to cap the Don. Oh, that's friggin' bad. To the trio? That's even worse than what Frankie's doing to that poor bastard downstairs. She's gonna take a long time to die.
The mobster muscle on the phone was talking about Mona. Punchinello's trio were nothing but bad news. Evidence that Punchinello didn't like me much.
The fact remains that all the victims so far identified in the Ragnarok shooting have been known criminals, many of whom had large doses of V in their blood. Reliable sources say that Max Payne was also among those killed, although no body has been recovered at this time.
Reliable sources. That meant somebody thought the Mafia had me, didn't want the cops snooping around anymore. The body would be delivered to them barely recognizable. Case closed. Don Punchinello had the power to be that reliable source, which was no news, but his news was old news. Framing me hadn't been enough. Don Punchinello had put a hit on me. He wanted me dead, and it had been important enough for him to give written instructions to Frankie about it.
Max Payne should die like a dog for the trouble he's caused. Frankie, I know I can trust you to give this matter the dedication it needs.
The hotel bar was fast developing quite a history. True to his words, Frankie was there, having a beer.
Jesus Christ. How the hell did you get loose?
Got bored waiting. thought, what the hell, we could just as well finish this here.
You've been a lovely audience. Had enough?
I don't play with girls anyway.
Unfair!
I spotted the tail as soon as I left the hotel. A big black Mercedes. I'd seen the car before. That time it had heralded impressive explosions. Vladimir was back.
Bang. You're dead, Max Payne.
I might have laughed if I remembered how. What's this supposed to be? Cops and robbers? Look, you want something with me? Get in line.
Peace, man. Relax. You know you are a real news item. Armed and dangerous. I am going to make you an offer you can't refuse. I've always wanted to say that.
It's a bum rap. I've been framed.
That's a moot point. Whatever you did or did not do, I'm sure you had good reason for doing it. Want to hear me out?
I'm listening.
Punchinello messing with V is bad for business all around. But that's not all. There is this guy, Boris Dine, used to pull jobs for me. He's the captain of the cargo ship Charon. Now the bastard turncoat has gone over to the other side, Punchinello's. The ship's loaded with high-res hardware, guns, my business. If Punchinello gets hold of that cargo, he's won and I have lost. And you'll have your work cut out for you. If you want to get to Punchinello, you will need heavy-duty persuaders. I am just the man to get them for you. Change the ship back under my flag, maybe pop two in the traitor Dime's head while you're at it. You'll get enough guns to start the apocalypse. You in or out?
Let's get this show on the road. Vladimir was one of those old-time bad guys with honor and morals, which made him almost one of the good guys. None of us was a saint. The Brooklyn riverfront was a maze of rusty containers, sharp bone cranes looming up from the snowstorm. On a night like this, you couldn't help but think of the dark army of dead men sleeping with the fishes, cement shoes in line. No Minotaur lurked in this labyrinth, but somewhere out there, on the clanking deck of his cargo freighter, the skipper of the Charon was waiting, like the ferryman of the River Styx.
Hold on, bitch.
doubted the letter was a receipt. Rico Muerte had come to town to do more than just sort out family troubles. Exhibits number 1, 2, and 3. A briefcase of money, a sniper rifle, and an envelope with one word neatly printed on a folded piece of expensive paper.
Mayor.
It didn't sound like a mafia contract at all. It was too cold and too to the point. I had found Boris Dime's ship. Rust had crept over the sides of the cargo steamer a long time ago. Boris Dime would be on board. I'd have to smoke half of his crew to even get near the gangplank. Guns were probably being kept in the hold, buried amidst the rats and oily water. Tell me, how much did Dime cost you? I bet it was more than his name.
Max Payne.
Right the first time.
You're dead, punk.
You sure you're not confusing me with Boris here? But you are right, of course. Pretty soon we should get together and have a talk.
You son of a...
Pissing Punchinello off was a dangerous game. But when people get mad, they make mistakes. I should know. That's where I wanted Punchinello, mad enough to trip over his own feet. Preferably into a grave.
Did you get everything you need?
Check.
I owe you. Anything you need.
This is my solo. When I'm through, Punchinello won't be anybody's problem anymore.
Clear as vodka. But anytime you get between a rock and a hard place, just whistle. This could be the beginning of a beautiful friendship.
You really get a bang out of this big-time gangster act, don't you? Even with all this firepower, I figured I couldn't get to Punchinello at his manor. I could only hope that he wouldn't pass a chance to hear me beg to see he's won. This is Max Payne. I want to cut a deal.
Payne, you're a dead man.
That's what everybody keeps telling me. I got your ship and her cargo. I want to meet. No pain, no gain. Capiche?
You know my restaurant?
Yeah, I know it.
One out.
Quincinello's restaurant had seen better days. Snow was falling like ashes from post-apocalyptic skies, but that was outside. Things would soon get hot in the Don's restaurant. I knew it was a long shot, Angelo Punchinello actually showing up, but there was no crime in hoping. Burning to get me. The feeling was mutual. He was trying to put out my flames with gasoline. The mobsters have been guarding a real treasure. The way out of this disco inferno. Vlad had seen my smoke signals. The Mercedes was revving to go, almost drowning out the banshee wail of the sirens.
You coming? We'll drop you off at the Punchinello Manor.
Sounds good to me.
When this is over, look me up. I could use a professional like you.
I'll keep that in mind. The night groaned with cold. The garden lights flickered nervously. In their light, the falling snow was dead white before the darkness ate it up. I had heard the stories. The trio were mad dogs. They'd have hung the heads of their enemies over the manor gates if the capo had only let them. Punchinello wanted pain. He'd see the pain. The trick in my situation was that there was no trick, no matter what the movies tell you. No rules, no secret mantra, no roadmap. It wasn't about how smart or how good you were. It was chaos and luck. And anyone who thought different was a fool. All you could do was to hang on madly, as long and as hard as you could. Someone had graciously left the back door open for me and killed the guards. My money was on Mona. I knew the trio would be standing between me and Punchinello. I had read their rap sheets, thick as phone books. No one would be walking out of here alive. The numbing cold of the broken night had followed me in. Upstairs, the trio tangoed down the manor halls to the silent rhythm of their murderous hearts. The blood of their victims rust on their lips. Vince Mignano, Pilot Providence, aka Big Brother, and Joe Deadpan Salem. The pistol was a frozen lump in my hand, piercing the skin, gnawing me to the bone. In death, the thug had been promoted to messenger. Someone hadn't enjoyed the Don's hospitality. Someone with a flair for the dramatic. Someone who had let herself out of a locked cell and passed a couple of armed guards.
My thoughts were on Mona again. I could only hope she was a good enough gambler to walk away while she was still winning, before she'd run into the trio. It didn't take me long to run into the trio. The word on Lisa Punchinello was that she was a bit of a witch. The tarot cards on the kitchen table fit the picture. They weren't my kind of cards, but I was willing to take a crack at the hand Mrs. Punchinello had dealt. The first card was the tower. Maybe that was supposed to be the manor. It got easy after that. The devil was the master of the house, and death was me. Coming for him. One down, two to go. For her.
You're a real angel, Max.
I couldn't tell whether it was Mona or her sister. The body was a mess. The sick bastard had really gotten a kick out of it. Seeing her lying there got me thinking about another woman's body on another bed. Got me thinking about a fallen cradle.
Max Payne.
Talk to me.
Alfred Woden. You've got company. An armed helicopter just landed on the manor grounds. You must hurry.
The more the merrier. Punchinello's trio was done for.
Outside my door. Hurry. It's coming for me. You gotta hurry. Please.
I could hear Punchinello on the phone begging for help. He should have been saying his goodbyes. Punchinello was a pushover. The moment I stepped into the room, he folded like a deuce before a royal flush.
No, wait. I was just doing what I was told. I couldn't refuse. She's someone high up. Government, maybe. I don't know.
He was trying to buy more sand for his hourglass. I wasn't selling any.
No, I told him not to...
Game over, Max Payne.
I could tell when I was outgunned. It was time to take another beating. The mystery witch was a real barracuda. Trouble on dagger heels, a smoking assault rifle in her hand, and an army of killer suits behind her.
How sweet. I get to kill two birds with one stone.
Sooner or later, it was going to catch up with you.
Mr. Payne. It's time to show you the benefits of my brew. Be a good boy now.
You'd find that Lady Luck was really a hooker.
Ah!
You were fresh out of cash.